Hello everyone and welcome back to 9 to 5 After Hours, the MCTV and Players collaboration for this year's spring musical, 9 to 5. I'm your host, Brylee Watkins, and today is unfortunately our last episode, but we will still have just as fun as the others. Today we will be talking to some of our lovely ensemble members, with our first two guests being Brylee and Anna. Hello guys!
Hi!
How are ya?
Good.
Good. So, obviously, you two are in the ensemble for 9 to 5, but that talks about being a lot of people in the show. So, who are you portraying in the ensemble?
So I play Missy, who is Hart's wife, mm-hmm. And then I'm also one of the like principal dancers, I guess you would say. So I'm in most of the musical numbers mm-hmm. in the background, doing something, getting thrown around.
What about you, Anna?
I play Margaret, who is a secretary and kind of the office drunk a little. and then I'm in some dance numbers as well.
Awesome. And this is your second show. Mm-hmm. And Brylee, this is your first show. So how is this being your first show? How is that experience?
It's been really fun. Everyone in Players has been really welcoming and really exciting. And the show itself is really fun to do. So it's been a really fun experience to get my foot in the door with something new. Mm-hmm. And to learn how Players works.
And how is it being in your second time, your second go around? How is this?
It's been great. I truly love it. It's been fun to get back into it and be busy every week. not that I'm not busy with school, but like it's just kind of nice for an extracurricular of kind of letting that creative side go a little.
And fills up the time.
It does.
It really fills up the time. But like you said, you both are in many, many songs in the background being thrown or doing something. So do you have a favorite song in it to be in, to dance in?
That's a really good question. Honestly, all of the music in the show is a lot of fun. Probably like singing for me, my favorite is probably Shine Like the Sun.
That is a fun one.
I think we're all off stage during that number. So all of the ensemble is just kind of singing their hearts out in the wings, which is fun. For dance, there are a few. Our choreographer Mark is so talented mm-hmm. and he put together really fun and creative numbers. Two of my favorites are probably One of the Boys and Cowgirl's Revenge. I get thrown around a lot in those two. So it's definitely fun.
And what about you, Anna?
I like to sing Backwoods Barbie. I'm off stage for that one.
It's
a fun one to sing. I also like to dance and also Cowgirl's Revenge. Mm-hmm. But I also like Heart to Heart. It's a little sassy. And so it's fun to come out and then be backup dancers to Roz.
Also, what are these titles of the songs?
I don't know.
Because every single time I talk to someone new, I was like, oh, what song are you going in today? Oh, Backwoods Barbie. And I was like,
Cowgirl's Revenge.
And I was very like, creative.
What is this about?
Dance of Death.
Yeah.
And I asked these in the first episode for the three main girls, and they had a few inside jokes. Does the ensemble have some inside jokes?
Yeah. I mean, we spend so much time together in rehearsal. Mm-hmm. Things are bound to come out. I think my favorite is in Shine Like the Sun. In the song, there's this like little run that the soprano section does that's like, shine. and the day we were learning, we were doing the vocal rehearsal for the song, I think it was CJ who had just like decided to do Opt Up and like do the soprano section.
As he does.
Yeah.
The song.
So like every time like me, John, and CJ are talking and like we don't know what to say or like it's an awkward situation or something, it's just a shine. Yeah, it's fun.
I think everyone referenced that song
throughout
the whole rehearsal and throughout the day.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I don't remember any particular inside joke personally, but I do know we are always confused with that.
Yeah.
I know, especially for me, I'm guessing on those lyrics.
Like the last rehearsal.
I try to make
rehearsal.
It sound good, but the last rehearsal, it was rough.
The Uh-oh. Last rehearsal we did, we all were making up different harmonies. Yeah. Like no one knew what was going on.
We all tried to match each other, but also sound good.
Just making it up. Like, that sounded good.
Yeah.
And lastly, what are you looking forward to most about each show?
Oh, that's such a good question. we've all been working really hard, so I think I'm most excited to put it in front of an audience and to feel their energy as we perform. Mm-hmm. That's always the best part of like doing any stage production is right. like live theater. Like you get to feel the audience's energy and they get to feel yours. So I'm really excited for everyone to see it and to come see what we've been working on.
I'm excited for like costumes, getting into the costumes, really diving into becoming our characters.
Right.
And so, yeah, I'm also just ready to see the set all together and like that first run through of it going hopefully smoothly before the shows, and then having everyone see the costumes. Our costume designers are great and fantastic. And so I'm ready for everyone to see that.
Awesome. Well, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for
and I can't
us.
Wait to see you in it.
Thank you.
Our next two guests are going to be CJ and Brooke.
Hello.
Hello, people. How are we?
So good.
Great.
All right. So you two are also in the ensemble.
Yes.
Who are you playing?
Brooke. Why don't you?
Okay. So I'm Roz. So I am the secretary of Mr. Hart in the show, who is absolutely in love with him and enthralled by him. Mm. The only one at that. Everyone else hates him. Mm. So she's a little geeky, a little nerdy. And then I just have some little cameos as a little cowgirl sometimes. I drop into some of the ensemble numbers doing a little dancing. But yeah, that's basically me.
What about you, CJ?
And I play Dick, who is Judy Burnley's husband, ex-husband.
Oh, okay.
Depends on the day of how he's feeling.
Oh, yeah.
If I'm going to be completely honest. He is not a nice person, but he just wants whatever he wants. And that's just who he is.
He is toxic.
He is toxic. He is a cheater, and that's really all you need to know about him.
All right.
Yes.
That's exactly who he is.
And you play great.
Thank you. Thank you. And then I'm also a featured dancer in some of the other numbers throughout the
awesome.
Show.
And Brooke, you have a whole number I saw the other night in a little rehearsal.
Yeah.
It was which very fun to watch. I loved it. But what is your number called, and what is it about?
Yeah, so I have my own little solo number. It's called Heart to Heart. And it's basically just about Roz's obsession with Mr. Hart and how much she loves him and how much she wishes that they could be together. And she's kind of crazy and all over the place. So there's a lot of dancing. There's a lot of moving. The backup dancers are amazing. So it's a lot of fun. And it's upbeat. It's a little jazzy. But gotta love it. Gotta love it. Thank you.
And I'll see CJ. This is your 100th show, may I say? Your 100th show with Players. So you've done it your entire college career so far.
Yeah.
How has Players shaped your college experience at Manhattan?
Players has been the best part about my time here at Manhattan. I've made some of my best friends for forever through this club. And I try and tell that to every new person that comes into this club is that even if you don't do every show, I didn't do every show. I did every musical, but I didn't do any of the plays. Even if you just do like one show a year, you can still find some of the most amazing people through this club. And that doesn't just mean cast members. That means the crew, the directing company, the producing company, whatever, whoever you interact with, you will find some of the nicest, most genuine people you will meet in college. And I swear by that.
I also swear by doing my second year in Players.
Same.
But this is your first show.
Yeah.
So how has it been? Can you attest to what CJ has said?
I can attest. No, it's been really great. I've gotten to meet like a bunch of cool people and people that I really just feel like I identify with and mesh well with. And it's kind of cool to see like this side of the school, because I think I'm involved in a lot of things outside of Players.
Yes, you are.
I'm involved in a lot of things outside of Players. Like, a little too much. But it's cool to, like, come to Players, and it's just a different environment. Mm-hmm. It's so much different than anything else I do. It's so, like, relaxing. Everyone's, like, a big, happy family. And everyone just gets along so well, mesh so well. And it's also just, like, an artistic, like, collaboration as a whole. Like, everyone is hoping for the best for everyone. There's no like competition or anything like that. It's all like everyone's there to help you and hope that you grow and learn. And I think that's really special about Players.
Awesome. And finally, why should people come see 9 to 5?
Do you want to go first?
Sure. I think people should come see 9 to 5 because It is a really upbeat musical. The music is written by Dolly Parton. The score is fantastic. The story of the show is very important to get across. It's very relevant also, which right. you think that a show that came out a long time ago, I mean, the musical hadn't come out that long ago, but the movie came out a while ago. You think that a story like that maybe would have changed, but unfortunately it hasn't. Mm-hmm. And you'll see that when you come see the show. It's a really, really fantastic show. Everyone in the cast is immensely talented. The set is gonna be amazing. The lighting, the sound, everything is just gonna be top tier. And I think that will come across because we've worked so hard. And I think that everyone is gonna really, really enjoy it.
Yeah. I think that I can also attest to the fact that there's something to relate to in every aspect, in every scene, in every song. There's something someone can relate to from the audience. So I think that's something really special about this show, because there's a lot of shows out there that like are otherworldly and you can't relate to them in any way and you're kind of just there for the ride. But I think 9 to 5 is something that's so special because it's relatable and it's comedic. So you get like the best of both worlds. You can kind of like relate it to your life and laugh about your life a little bit. And I think that's fun. And I also think like we have so many, like you said, so many talented people in this cast. And a lot of them are seniors and right. are older and they're leaving. We're never gonna have this cast again. And you don't wanna miss out on that. You don't wanna miss out on this talent. It's so good. So definitely come.
Well, awesome. Thank you guys for coming in today.
Thank
and
you.
I can't wait to see you doing it.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching 9 to 5 After Hours. It's been so much fun to follow along with the production and talk to some really talented people. But don't forget to see 9 to 5 the musical on April 21st, 22nd, and 23rd.
Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me.